ticket, you talking thick hit. I was kicking in houses for it. That's two different tickets, right? Oh, yeah, they loud, boy. Them players lazy, they don't get no bread. Yeah, they be counting, boy. Them labels scouting, boy. They talking M's only the thousand, boy. I had to get you touch and it get you foul, boy. I'm talking, you out of bounds, boy. They always screaming, reach me snapping. I say the collar, boy. I'ma lose the roof and the stain. Please don't test me like on that, boy, Johnny. And ain't talking dang. It's like everything look cut them drop. They go insane, they want to pitch. Ain't gonna get in the beef. I'ma just make them blitz. Round four deep in the sprinter. That's your girl, and she in my rental. We had cable, we ain't even had no tunnel. They change the channel and they see me. I'm signing deals and not no plea. Burglary, B&E, don't you size me like no rapper.
It's week 14 of the National Football League, and today's clash of conferences is just moments away. It's the Chargers and the Lions, and it's coming up next on EA Sports.
Coming to you from the venue that hosted the Super Bowl back in February of 06. Welcome to Ford Field in downtown Detroit. Both teams emerging from the Ford Field tunnels just a short time ago. And, of course, the loudest cheers were reserved for the hometown Lions. They're set to go as they will match up with the Los Angeles Chargers. Brandon Gordon alongside the one and only Charles Davis. And CD, lots of compelling storylines in a game like this. Let's take a look at some of the numbers for these two offenses.
And I'm glad you brought up the numbers, because sometimes it's hard to quantify a team's performance solely by judging the numbers. But I think with these two teams, what you see is a pretty accurate representation of who they are.
Here's the first carry for Austin Ekeler. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. The numbers for him from a week ago, 18 carries, 101 yards, and a score.
He's having a nice season, and he knows where he ranks in the league. Don't ever let a running back tell you that they don't know that. They do. So what he's doing now is lobbying the offensive coordinator all week long. Hey, how about a few more touches? He's one big game away from maybe leading the league.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
On the give, this is Ekeler. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down.
Now I think we're going to get a timeout here. Yes, a timeout here, as it looks like we've got a Lion that's shaken up.
The last run got a couple here, second and 8.
While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break.
Escaping the pressure right. Wide open, it's Allen, complete.
And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20.
A big gain that time for the Chargers.
So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down.
They'll try the right side with Ekeler. And he'll get about 3 as he's taken down at the 14-yard line.
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
And he'll get about 3 just outside the 10, stopped at the 11.
But that call makes sense, because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing shotgun, and they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
And he's in for a Charger touchdown. Austin Ekeler with touchdown number 12 on the year. And the Chargers take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive.
Well, first quarter, maybe too early to talk about statement drives, Charles, but that sure seemed like a statement drive right there.
Well, if we're going to talk about statement drives, I think what they're saying is we're going to establish the run. They gave it to him early and often on this drive, and he wound up taking it into the end zone.
Extra point by Koo, up and good, and that makes the score 7-0. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25.
Four down, four down.
They'll run for the first time with DeAndre Swift.
And he'll maneuver his way forward for about four. Second and six.
These are his numbers from last week's contest. 13 carries and even 60 yards and a touchdown.
Well, watching the film, we saw that things clicked pretty well for them in the running game last week. No reason to change in my mind. Continue to try and run the football. Give it to them early and often in hopes of breaking down the defense so some bigger gains result as the game goes on.
And 6 yards to go.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. And Shark hauls it in. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. Here comes the Lions punter now, as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. And just a single punt for him in the loss last week as he sends this one away. This will be fielded at the 17. 51 yards on the punt there. And possession will switch hands, first and 10.
Herbert and the Chargers now with a first and 10
at their own 27. Throwing to start the drive.
Herbert
over the middle, and it's caught. Keenan Allen. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
Certainly no settling into the drive there. They came right out on the first play and attacked the middle of the field for a big gainer and a first down.
And the Lions pressure too strong. Down he goes. Marching in for the sack, Michael Brockers.
A hole to dig out of here, second and 17.
Another try after the first down sack.
Herbert
going deep here for Allen. And it's intercepted.
Picked by Jeff Okuda. And the Lions are going to take over at their own 41. So they tried to take the deep shot there, but this defense up to the task.
And a lot of times when you air a ball out like this, if it does get intercepted, there's going to be a lot of space out there to set up a return. And remember, you've got five big offensive linemen out there playing on their feet in open space. Not a skill most of them possess that allows for extra yardage on the return.
And they'll try the jet sweep here. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Let's just make this one succinct. Nice job there. All 11 guys on defense diagnosing the jet sweep and putting it down.
On second down, Swift. And he'll be close to a first down at the Chargers 41. Call it a gain of 5 there on the run, but they'll remain a yard or two short here with third down coming up. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. And they'll let their fullback try and push the pile. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. He needed 2, he got 1, and that's going to leave him with 4th down and a yard. To the football, it's blocked, it's picked up, a look down the numbers, there he goes, 20,
what a play, what
touchdown
a play.
LA, a great play there, his first touchdown on the year, and the Chargers get the quick strike touchdown. Ku able to connect on the extra point, and it's now 14-0.
Chargers 14, Lions nothing.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback. And Detroit back in possession of the football.
Last time they had a little bit of a special teams breakdown. That field goal was blocked.
Yeah, and everything has to be precise in the kicking game. Snap, hold, kick. Obviously, the blocking to keep people out. So what you really want to do is get in there and get 6 points and take the pressure off of those guys.
Yeah, another negative play in an early down situation. This one to start the drive. You're putting a lot of pressure on your quarterback to bail you out when you're in second and long yardage.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. Looking to throw. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far and brings up third down. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. They'll look to throw here. And he's caught on the sideline, but he's not going to have a first down. They say he was out of bounds. So a big call there. That brings up fourth.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage. And just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done.
And on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. Officially, that'll go as a 52-yard punt. Not too shabby. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. The Charger drive about to get going. They are coming off the game last week, which a very interesting game. And, Charles, ultimately, it ended in a tie.
And that's difficult on teams because, let's face it, Brandon, they just don't know how to react. I mean, who does? Did you win? No. Did you lose? No. Because when you win, you jump up and down. Life's good. When you lose, you set your face in that stone look so that you show that you weren't hurt. I think it's one of those things that at the end of the year, you find out just how you're supposed to feel about that tie. Did it help you or hurt you in the standings? Then you'll know what you really should have felt that game.
Throwing again on second and 10. Herbert. This one into the hands of Jalen Camp. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
And he'll work this forward for about 3 at second down.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
A throw over the middle, taken in. And it's going to be another first down as they'll get him to the ground at the Lions' 25-yard line.
And the Chargers' first down.
Herbert now. Trying to force it to Allen, and it's intercepted. Picked by Jeff Okuda. And the Lions are going to get the football back at their own 17. So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Looking right sideline, but it's incomplete.
They've been playing sound fundamental defense thus far and able to keep this offense from creating a major dent on the scoreboard.
Able to force the incompletion, but still waiting for that game-changing play. You feel like it's coming, the first sack, the first turnover.
In a sense, they're playing old-school defense right now. The new-school defense is what you said, taking the ball away.
No gain on that one as it brings up a 3rd and 10. Coming up at halftime, I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando, the coach. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman, both larger than life.
No doubt about it.
But you're stuck with me in this booth,
yes,
and he's
I
miles
am.
Away and smiling.
And happy.
Here comes the Lions punter now, as he's on to kick it away. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. That'll be put in the books as a 53-yard punt. And that will come the offense as they take over. The Charger drive about to get going. And 2 interceptions thrown here in this first half. You hear it, no matter the sport, they say the great athletes, they can kind of have a short-term memory, but that's easier said than done.
It is easier said than done, but I played with a guy who threw 2 interceptions in the first quarter of a really big game we were playing.
Johnny Unitas?
And no, not quite a bit.
And under the Lions' pressure, he's brought down.
The Lions will use the first of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside.
Surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. The Lions now going to use the second of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. And in their own territory, needing only a few inches, they're going to line up to go for this thing on fourth down. They'll run for it with Eckler. And this will depend on the mark. I'm not sure he pushed the line forward. And indeed, he did not. They stop him from the 32 now. Here's first and 10. They'll try and start this drive in the air. He gets this complete to Cephas. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. The Lions into the red zone for the first time. They have a first and 10 at the 18. He's going to get that to Swift underneath. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. The Lions quickly now going to use the last of their timeouts as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. This is first and goal and a golden chance to get a score back here before halftime. They'll set up a throw. And that's going to be incomplete. 12 seconds left.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
All right, Captain. It's batting down the hatches time defensively. Dodge two pass attempts to the end zone. Now what do you think they're going to try and dial up on third and goal?
Well, knowing them and knowing what we just seen, I think they're throwing it again, don't you?
I think you have to. I think in,
in trouble, and he'll go down back at the 12. So we have reached halftime intermission with the visiting Chargers on top. And okay, so much for our halftime break. Apparently we're going to get right back to it.
All right, Coach, thank you very much as we welcome you back for quarter number three.
It'll be Lions football to start the second half, and they trail here as we get back underway on EA Sports. No run back here to begin the half, and we will start at the 25-yard line. The Lions offense now with a football first here to begin quarter number three. And right out of the gate, they face what you'd think could be a pretty important drive.
I would say so. You know, they're down two scores. That's not the end of the world. It wasn't the strongest of first halves, but for them to start calling back, they've got to start putting more pressure on that defense, start cutting into this deficit. You can't have three and outs and expect to get that done.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. And the Chargers rush is going to get there. Down he goes. He'll wind up losing a full 9 yards here on the sack. Now it's third down. He'll drop to throw.
He'll find Swift out of the backfield.
And this effort will not get it done. He stopped well short of the first down at the 29. It'll be a pickup of 13, but it'll still lead to a fourth down.
We can make this one pretty simple. Locked up all of his progressions downfield, forced to get it to his running back. But how about the way they ran to the football and knocked him down to force a fourth down?
Good open field tackling there. A 50-yard punt followed by just a 1-yard return. The Charger drive about to get going. Now Herbert with it, looking to pass. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked by Jeff Okuda. And this return is going to be halted right around the 28-yard line. I think it's safe to say this is a game he's not going to forget anytime soon, Charles. Three interceptions.
It's rare that we see three interceptions by one team, let alone by an individual. And I think that after the second one, he's probably telling his teammates, any ball that's in the air is going to be mine. And that turned out to be true.
Second and nine now. Nowhere to turn here, and he's going to go down. Back at about the 37-yard line. He'll wind up losing a full 9 yards here on the sack. Now it's third down. They'll set up to throw. And that's complete. It's Chris Godwin. And in for the Lions touchdown. Chris Godwin. His ninth touchdown of the season. And thanks to the interception, the Lions offense cashes in with six. Extra point splits the uprights, and that'll cut the lead down to a touchdown. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Taken at the goal line. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The Charger drive about to get going. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now.
And that's caught inside the 30. And all the way in for a Charger touchdown. Josh Palmer, his second touchdown on the season. And the Chargers are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. And boy, CD, it's one thing to watch a great run, but when it's a great run with broken contact, it's like a cherry on top. That was a nice play.
Yeah, and this is one of the best runs you'll see. A lot of times on these long touchdowns, you'll see he gets into the end zone untouched, but not here. He fought his way through contact, and it barely even registered, and he just continued down the field all the way to the end zone.
And you can see the distance traveled there after the initial contact on the next-gen stats. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And this will be a touchback, so they'll bring it out to the 25. And Detroit getting set to go now. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. And that's out to the flat for Swift. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. They're going to look to throw. And he'll get this into the hands of Swift once again. And a 5-yard gain gets him to the 42. Think about the strong safety position. Yeah, they're the more bulkier guys in the free safety, but that time, great athleticism to hustle in and break up that play. Second and five. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
I'm getting the sense that this offense is getting frustrated. Here we are into the third quarter, and they've had plenty of opportunities to get in sync. Thus far, that hasn't happened. They're looking for answers, both on the sidelines and in the huddle looking at each other.
Chargers able to get the pressure and bring him down. Joey Bosa in there to get him, and on the season now, that is 9 sacks for him.
Well, here's where having mobility sometimes can work against you as a quarterback. He thinks he can retreat and outrun the pressure. But that time, they zeroed in on him and took him down for a big loss, partner.
A really big loss. It'll be a 51-yard punt that time. The Charger drive about to get going. And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time, see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
And you would have thought they would have been ready the last
true.
Time.
That's
I mean,
true.
That's what you work on all the time. Make sure that no one gets behind you. That's the cardinal sin of defense, not giving up the long pass. They did. Let's see how they adjust.
Clearly wasn't outside of the tackle box. There's your penalty.
And accompanying that penalty, a loss of down.
Now it's Herbert. And that falls to the ground incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively. And now it brings up third down. Here's Herbert. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Will Harris. This defense figured out something in the locker room. That's two third-quarter picks now.
And you just wonder, did he get too comfortable in the locker room himself? His team has the lead. Take care of the football. He's putting him in jeopardy right now.
And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and eight coming up.
Well, they still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
Fights him off. And he'll be close to a first down at the Charger 17. That's going to be a 6-yard gain and leaves him with third down and just a yard to go. They'll try and run here with Swift. And he takes it down to the 13 and picks up the first. Ford Field, and that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. That catch good for only a couple. Second and eight. At the 12-yard line. They'll drop to throw. He's got it. Touchdown. Chris Godwin. Two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Lions have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. Extra point right down the middle. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. On the return, Clay. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28. Heading back out, the Chargers offense. We get a peek at the playoff picture in the AFC. As of this moment, as pretty much everyone knows, they sit alone in that top spot. But nothing is guaranteed. They haven't even clinched the playoffs. So a good start, but a long way to go.
And you know, a blunt veteran inside their locker room has stood up at one point or another and said, you know all this means nothing so far. We've got to cover this, get it done. What do we want to be? It's like winning a title in August, right, in preseason. Doesn't count. Let's go ahead and get this thing done.
And he's taken down right at the 45-yard line. So on the other side of the field now, it's first and 10 as they've got things rolling on this drive. A handoff, it's Eckler. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. From the shotgun, here's Herbert out to his left. He's got the first down here inside the 30. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. First down, Chargers. A play fake, and now Herbert to throw. Eluding the pressure right. And he will reach the 5-yard line before going out of bounds.
Containing him is becoming a big problem. We've already seen this once earlier on this drive.
Yeah, and so now two times this has happened. Do you adjust something?
Yeah, I think you do. I think you got something about your rush lanes. Try not to either get too wide or too narrow. Make sure someone is there waiting for him to take off.
It'll be a pickup of four, and it brings up second and goal. Eckler will take this into the end zone for a Charger touchdown. Well, that's certainly going to bump up the old win probability index because now it's a 2-score game here in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, you're taking me into that deep water now. Win probability index, This game's definitely not over. We're not looking at a half percent or something. It's just two scores. But the way that this team has played, to me, what I've seen, they absolutely deserve to win this game. They've been the better team by far throughout.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. No run back here, down to a knee, and this drive will start at the 25. Detroit's offense ready to take over. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
And this is a leaping effort, but it's knocked away and incomplete. DJ Chark, the intended target, but it'll be second down. He'll look to throw. This one taken in by Cephas. And he's able to get this one up to his 30 before he's out of bounds. 5 yards. Now it's third and five. Now back to throw. And this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on third down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to. Gotta try it here. He's back to throw. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Lions turned away on fourth down, and the Chargers will get the football back in excellent field position. Herbert will give this one to Eckler. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down. So it's Charger football as we welcome you back from the two-minute warning. They've got a third down now as they look for one more first down to help salt this one away. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. And whistles, and we're going to have another stoppage of play as they call the timeout on defense with 1:53 left. A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is first and goal. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And they'll get this from the 8 to the 5. Pickup of 3. The Lions now going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Eckler going to get it again on second down. And this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line. A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, third and goal. Here is Eckler, and he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. 2 yards on the pickup there, it's fourth down.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough in run support, and I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
Further. Well, he was a spectator for much of this game. This is his first field goal opportunity of the entire contest, but he's able to connect.
Yeah, he had a pretty good seat to this one, didn't he? But let's face it, all kickers that you and I know, they want to contribute. They want their opportunity, and he seized his.
And this will not be returned. It's a touchback, and they'll begin at the 25. Out comes this field general once more, leading his offense back onto the field. And those numbers, they kind of tell the story of his game so far. Started off not so hot. Now he's really heated up.
And remember, he signed up for duty as the guy who leads the team, right? The field general, the signal caller. So when things go rocky early, he can't just exit out and ask someone else to pick things up. He's got to do it himself, and that's what he's done here in this game.
And this throw incomplete.
Now the defender all over him that time, and it's going to lead to third down.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Back to throw here.
And that is knocked away in the middle of the field and incomplete.
This has been a rough one, to put it mildly, for him. And after this one's done, you just feel like at the post-game press conference, this team's going to have a lot of questions and definitely not a lot of answers.
Now they go for it on fourth, but this one is going to wind up incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and the Chargers will get the football back in excellent field position.
To a knee, and that should just about write it into this one.
So this one's over. It's in the win column for the LA Chargers. And you've got to say, CD, it was the defense who had a big part in the W.
Well, without question. When you force four turnovers, you get to enjoy the spoils of victory, don't you? It's right.
Making industry music. They want me to cap to y'all, but ain't gon' cap to y'all, cause y'all went there when they ain't had a ball. He tough as 40s. Wonder how he felt watching his dog casket fall. I had to tell my YG stop. He don't like to pass the ball. That chicken, he talking big hit. I was kicking in houses for it. Got two different tickets, right? Oh, yeah, they louder, boy. Them players lazy, they don't get no bread. Yeah, they be counting, boy. Them labels scouting, boy. They talking M's only the 1,000, boy. I like to get too tight and to get too foul, boy. I'm talking, you out of bounds, boy. And stain. Please don't test me like on that boy Jenny. And ain't talking games. It's like everything look cut them drop. They go insane, they wanna pick. Ain't gonna get in the beef. I'ma just make them blitz. Round four deep in the sprinter. Hottest your girl, and she in my rental. We had cable, we ain't even have no tunnels. They change the channel and they see me. I'm signing deals and not no plea. Burglary, being neat. Don't you size me like no rapper. I be quick to grab my ski. Get my sweet, but I be switching.